En ligne, dans la rue, à la télévision, partout des images des mannequins émaciés ayant été chirurgicalement et numériquement modifiés au point de devenir méconnaissables. Pour une femme ou une fille, il est impossible d'échapper à ces omniprésentes représentations irréelles de la beauté qui mettent en valeur la minceur extrême et la jeunesse éternelle. Au pays, quelques 600 000 à 990 000 Canadiens et Canadiennes répondraient aux critères de diagnostic d'un trouble de l'alimentation à un moment donné. Ce chiffre est encore plus alarmant dû au fait que les troubles alimentaires sont potentiellement mortels. On estime que le taux de mortalité globale associé avec l'anorexie mentale serait de 10 à 15 soit le taux le plus élevé de toutes les maladies mentales. Pourtant, il y a un manque de ressources et de coordination pour le traitement des troubles de l'alimentation. Sur les 4100 psychiatres que compte le Canada, seulement 12 sont spécialisés dans les troubles de l'alimentation. Dans plusieurs régions du Canada, il est impossible de bénéficier d'un ensemble complet de soins, depuis les soins ambulatoires jusqu'aux soins à long terme d'hospitalisation en résidence. Nous ne pouvons plus tolérer l'inaction du gouvernement conservateur face aux troubles alimentaires. Ce sont les raisons pourquoi j'ai déposé une motion aujourd'hui afin d'établir une stratégie nationale en matière de troubles alimentaires et l'image corporelle. En plus du dépôt de la motion, j'ai lancé une campagne web pour une image corporelle diversifiée dans les médias, www.soyonsrealistes.ca, avec le soutien de l'organisme Équilibre et Anorexie et Boulimie Québec. For many Canadians, seeking treatment for eating disorders is an uphill battle. It is often difficult for individuals with eating disorders to acknowledge their disorder and to seek the support of family and friends. Receiving an official diagnosis from a medical professional is also challenging, as is gaining access to treatment and follow-up support services. Canadians with eating disorders often have to wait for months before receiving treatment due to the limited number of treatment programs. Moreover, there is a dire lack of research into potential treatments. Imagine if there were 4 to 6 months wait times for prostate cancer treatment. This would be unacceptable. However, for example, in the province of Ontario, for a population of 12 million, there are only 3 treatment centers that have inpatient beds. This is unacceptable. And to think that the Conservatives still plan to cut $36 billion in transfers to provinces for healthcare. Those suffering from eating disorders and their families can't wait any longer for help from the federal government. That's why I've tabled a motion today to put into place a national strategy on eating disorders. In addition to tabling a motion in the House, I've launched an online campaign, www.berealcanada.ca, asking for more body diversity in the media. J'aimerais maintenant passer la parole à Fanny Dagenet, présidente de l'organisme Équilibre, qui travaille pour prévenir et diminuer les problèmes reliés au poids et à l'image corporelle.
Saviez-vous qu'au Québec, près d'un jeune sur deux est insatisfait de son corps? Cette insatisfaction corporelle affecte non seulement l'estime de soi de nos jeunes, mais les amène aussi à adopter des comportements nuisibles, voire dangereux pour leur santé. Pour atteindre la silhouette de leurs rêves, de nombreux jeunes vont sauter des repas, s'entraîner de façon obsessive ou encore commencer à fumer. Chez certains jeunes, l'insatisfaction corporelle prendra une telle ampleur qu'elle pourra mener au développement de troubles alimentaires. Il faut le dire, les pressions sociales pour se conformer à des idéaux de beauté irréalistes sont très fortes. Aujourd'hui, des corps parfaits et retouchés sont utilisés pour vendre n'importe quoi, pas seulement des produits de beauté et des vêtements. Le pouvoir d'influence des médias et de la publicité est très important à cause de la portée de leurs messages et de leur image. Pour cette raison, il est important de les impliquer dans le changement des normes sociales pour les amener à présenter des corps sains et diversifiés. Il importe également de sensibiliser les jeunes et les adultes qui les entourent, puisqu'ils sont des consommateurs de demain. Depuis près de 20 ans maintenant, l'organisme Équilibre met en place des actions de prévention de l'insatisfaction corporelle dans les écoles et dans les organismes communautaires. Il est important d'aider les jeunes à développer leur jugement critique face au modèle unique de beauté et de les inciter à s'ouvrir à la différence pour ainsi réduire les préjugés à l'égard de l'obésité. Les jeunes doivent aussi prendre conscience de leur pouvoir d'influence sur l'industrie. Enfin, il importe de cibler les parents, car ils ont un rôle de modèle, et ce, dès la petite enfance. Tous les adultes qui gravitent autour du jeune ont aussi le pouvoir d'influencer positivement le rapport que nos jeunes ont avec leur corps. De l'intervenante en service de garde jusqu'au directeur d'école, en passant par l'entraîneur sportif et l'enseignante français, chacun a une responsabilité auprès des jeunes et peut faire la différence. En somme, chaque acteur de la société devrait se sentir interpellé par cette question, qui menace tant la santé physique que mentale des générations de demain. Je vous remercie de votre attention.
Merci beaucoup, Fanny. On va maintenant accepter des questions.
What you envision a national strategy saying and what you hope it would accomplish?
So we've set up the text in a national strategy to really take into account all the testimony that was brought forward to the Standing Committee on the Status of Women last year. And so what many stakeholders called for was a strategy on education, on awareness and on prevention, but also strategy on treatment as such, on sharing best practices, on creating a registry on eating disorders, and on investing in research on eating disorders, research that's currently lacking in Canada.
I know your party's dissenting report from that committee said the same thing, and when it was put to the government, they basically deflected to the provinces and said this kind of stuff, like mandating wait times, that kind of thing, is up to the provinces. Do you have any, I guess, optimism that they might adopt this, or why would a national strategy be better than the provinces doing it for themselves?
Mm-hmm. And obviously it's important to respect provincial jurisdiction, and that wording is very clear in my motion, that the federal government would work with provinces and territories and the First Nations in the development of a strategy. Obviously healthcare is within provincial jurisdiction, but it is important to have a national strategy simply to be able to coordinate services and share best practices in many regions in Canada, especially in regions outside of urban centers. It's very difficult to receive treatment for eating disorders. We see a huge unequal access to treatment across the country. And so it's really important for the federal government to take action in terms of spearheading research funding for eating disorders. This is absolutely something that the federal government should take upon itself.
Even in big cities, the treatment waits are super long. I know exactly. One of the doctors that heads the biggest program, Dr. Woodside, I think his name, testified that, a 5'5 woman at 60 pounds will wait 3 to 4 months to get into his program.
Exactly.
Why do you think the government is hesitant to enact some sort of federal strategy to deal with that? He said if this was a man's disease, people would be in the streets upset about this.
Exactly, and I think there continues to be a lot of maybe taboos. People are still unwilling to talk about eating disorders as such. I think it's an important thing to bring before the House of Commons. It's largely, although men also suffer, men and boys also suffer from eating disorders, it's largely a women's issue. Currently, in the House of Commons, I'm taking advantage of my platform as a young female MP as well, since I have many peers that are affected by this problem, to bring this issue forward. I'm not sure why the government hasn't acted yet on this issue that touches so many Canadians, but I hopefully will get support across the House from all parties in support of this motion.
How much have you heard from people who are trying to seek treatment, who have gone elsewhere to other countries to seek treatment? What sort of feelings and do you sense from people who suffer from eating disorders?
It's an upward battle. I know that for many it takes years and years to receive treatment, to deal with the eating disorder. I've spoken to women across the country who've had to go overseas to seek treatment for eating disorders. The stories are horrifying, and the stories are really we don't realize how serious this is. Many people seeking treatment for eating disorders have to find themselves in a very precarious financial situation because these treatments are extremely expensive. They need to reach out to their family and friends for support. Oftentimes, because there's still taboos existing within society around eating disorders, this is, finding adequate support is problematic. It's been mentioned that many health professionals, unfortunately, lack specialized knowledge on eating disorders, and so that's another barrier to accessing treatment.
On the research aspect of things. I know that in that study, they pointed quite often, and the government continues to point to, like, a larger section of mental health research in general, and not a specific amount. Can you sort of tell me what you see as the amount of money the government is spending currently just on eating disorder research, and what you think it should be?
Well, we've seen cuts to CIHR. We've seen cuts to health research for women under this government. We've seen cuts to research around Aboriginal health under this government. And so we do see a downward trend in terms of research funding, something that we find very problematic. You know, my motion doesn't set into place, any allocated or doesn't put a number on this, but I think it's really important that we continue to support research that's in the interests of public health, and also research around women. And we don't have, as we heard from witnesses during the committee testimony, we don't have adequate research on what treatment works, what treatment is the best. And so that really leaves people suffering from eating disorders in the lurch.
Minister Ambrose bears some additional or some sense of additional responsibility, given she's a woman.
I think this is something that touches MPs from, all walks of life. I've spoken in the, the hallways of the House of Commons to my colleagues from different parties. Everyone knows someone who's been affected by an eating disorder or by a lack of self-esteem related to body image. It's something that affects men and boys as well as women and girls. And I know that a lot of men have, sisters, partners, friends who suffer from eating disorders as well. So I hope that this is something that can get support from all of my colleagues within the House of Commons. Thank you.
Est-ce que c'est correct si je parle en français? Okay, my English isn't very good, but I will try. But I will just add that everybody should be concerned about this because, like I said, in Quebec, 50% of teenagers have body dissatisfaction, and it brings them to skip meals, to smoke, to do all kinds of dangerous behaviors. And so everybody should be concerned. And if we don't do anything to prevent eating disorders, all those kids that are skipping meals or that are trying to control their weight, it can go to the development of eating disorders. So we have to do something and we have to prevent it. And I think it's a matter of health, it's a matter of mental health, and it's a matter of self-esteem also for the next generation.
Have you seen any signs from either the provincial government in Quebec or the federal government that they're paying attention to body image issues, thinking about how kids are, learning about food, all that? Have you seen any indications, or is this more on a level of, like, organization by organization trying to tackle it?
In Quebec, we are very lucky because we have the Quebec Charter for a healthy and diverse body image. And Equilibre, we are doing activities in schools since about 20 years. And also, we've been doing sensitization? No.
Education
of the media, fashion, and publicity industry. And we're giving awards to the industry that are trying to present more healthy body image. So we have a lot of initiatives, but I think we have to do more because it's a very important matter.